Good morning. How good looking is this?
Check it out.
James put trousers on so that I don't record him like he recorded me in my underwear.
You'll get your chance.
Yeah.
Oh, this is amazing. Spot. Look at that valley. So we're heading that way today for, I don't know, we don't really know where we're staying tonight actually. We're going to wing it a little bit.
But you can see some of the mountains. Look at this one.
So you can see the snow-cat ones over there as well.
And this one, kind of. But you, oh, anyway. We're going to get some breakfast.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go. All right, enough of that song. So we didn't really know where we were going, but we started heading east towards Gilgit. You pretty much follow the Gilgit River the entire way. And I cannot describe how beautiful it is. I'm actually not sure why there's not more people around. I thought there'd be like people rafting and kayaking down it. It is amazing. How are you guys doing? Good? Video. All right. So, James is having shitty luck again.
Flat tire number two.
What's that again?
Flat tire number two.
In how many days?
3 days?
Yep.
But none for like 6 months.
And two in 3 days.
This one's really flat. The last one was just, we actually worked out it's just the valve leaking.
Yeah.
But this one looks like it's proper flat. Anyway, we're gonna have to whip it off and see what's going on.
So, operation get the bike back on the road. We got the tire out and there is quite a big hole in it. I'm not sure if you can see that. So I'm not sure how that happened, but we'll try fix that later because I don't know if you can see, but the heavens are starting to open up behind us, so it'll be good to get back on the road ASAP.
And back on the road we went. So we did a final push towards Gilgit, where we spent one night. And then we were told about this Naltar Valley, where there's a lake somewhere around here. Meant to be a beautiful ride, so that's where we went.
Hello. I am police.
Okay, hi.
Sorry? Entry.
Yeah, we did it down the bottom.
Police, check post, Naltar.
Yeah, we did the passport.
No, this. Continent Hotel, Naltar Vala.
Sorry?
Naltar Valley, Continent Hotel. Backside, police check post.
We have to go backwards?
Huh?
This is G.
How far?
Yes.
It's sometimes hard to stay positive with all these, what we think are unnecessary police checks, especially when it's cold and it's raining and they turn you around and send you back down the hill and you can't really find where you're going. It's not really well signed. Ultimately, you just need to keep a smile on your face, be polite. They usually are polite to you and crack on, I guess.
Police? Okay. Hello, is this police?
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello.
Hello. Are you how police? Are you? Oh, good, how are you? Police?
Coming.
Thank please,
you. Where do you want to go this?
Naltar Lake.
Naltar Lake?
Yeah.
Sorry, it's impossible.
Impossible.
Because of the road blockage.
The road's blocked.
Yes.
Oh.
This police officer was great. He ended up just sitting us down and we had some tea with him. And then he phoned a friend and said that, and asked if we could get through on our motorbikes. And the friend said it shouldn't be a problem. So luck was on our side and we're headed into Naltar Valley. This dude's car is stuck in the worst spot. So we've just cleared some rocks, and I guess we'll see what happens. Not gonna be easy getting through here. Woo! This is gonna be fun.
It's a lot harder than it looked, by the way.
But the cool thing is, I mean, I was hoping this was gonna happen. Look, we're going on some snow. Yeah.
Let's do this. We're gonna head there before the downpour happens.
All right.
All right.
Good luck ahead.
I don't think this is gonna work. Oh, look at this guy. He just goes over the top.
You said it all the time, you never like that. Put it in the trunk and never write back. Got my shit like it's tighter than facts. Keep my shit light. Hey, hey, oh.
Hello. Hi.
All right, so we got past the snow, and now we're on a riverbed.
So we're gonna go that way and
right. Basically, see, that's the snow. It's kind of come down and screwed up our path. So now we're in the middle of a riverbed. James, what happened?
I got stuck in this beautiful... The grass was working perfectly until we hit the moss. I don't really know how... Well, it's going to be interesting.
That was something. That was amazing though.
That was one hell of an adventure.
So we've got you. This is... what's it called?
I don't know. A lake.
Naltar Lake. Naltar Lake. The lake's actually over there. We found these cool little camp spots. Man, it is really cool up here. It is raining. It is pretty cold. But we're the only people up here. Hello!
Hello! Oh, didn't work.
James is yodeling.
My hands are too cold.
Anyway, it's f***ing cold, so we're going to quickly set the tents up.
Whistling.
Oh.
This is really cool though. Look at this. Yoo! Hello! Very cool. But getting dark, so time to put the tents up.
When we wake, hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun.
We have a few friends for breakfast. Hey, buddy. Very curious, they keep coming up and checking out what's going on. If you move in the slightest way, they'll run away.
Hey!
I think they can smell the onion.
The onion? These guys love onions, apparently.
Yeah, beautiful onions.
It's beautiful, though. This is Ramas.
Ooh, coffee. Hey, hey.
Hey, that's enough now.
Hey.
Oh, they're fighting each other now. Go on. Jesus, look at them fighting.
Doesn't get much better than this. Own avalanche waterfall in the background. Camping. The sun's finally out. We've had some friends show up. The weird looking bull cow thing.
Very inquisitive friends who keep poking our bites.
Very curious. But look at this. Mountains everywhere. And avalanche waterfalls. It's been going on for probably 3 or 4 minutes now. Just keep falling. It was a pretty cold night though. It was snowing a little bit. But by the time we woke up, it all melted. Yeah, but rain, mostly rain. Rain. A little bit of snow.
Look, it's still going.
Now we're heading northeast towards a place called Hunza.
Yeah, Hunza's kind of like the tourist capital of this area, but being Ramadan, it's still quite quiet.
Yeah.
We've made our way up to the viewpoint overlooking the whole town, and it's pretty impressive.
We only spent one night in Hunza, and then we pressed on, got back on the road, and headed further northeast towards Passu. The mountains you can see in the distance there are called the Passu Cones. They're one of like the main attractions here. We got our standard photos, and then we pressed on to try find a campsite. Now we quite often use an app called iOverlander. It's for Android, it's for iOS, and if you're doing a trip like this, it's highly recommended. Basically, all other overlanders can recommend places to sleep, places to camp, places to eat, or find fresh water, pretty much everything. And, you know, usually it is spot on and gives you some great suggestions. This time, it really missed the mark. We got to this lake and it was dry and sandy and not flat. Really wasn't that great. So we had to come up with another plan. Alright, so we're stoked because that other lake, like you said, was still pretty cool, but this is better.
This is a lot better.
Not dusty, we've got this beautiful little spot. We're at the Cathedral View guest house.
Guest house slash camping.
Slash camping, and it cost us
$2 a night.
$2!
We've got a bathroom we can use, there's electricity in the restaurant behind us.
At night time, there's electricity.
And apparently there's Wi-Fi at night as well. So we're stoked at this place. You know, the river's just there. The cones are just over there. We're going to spend two nights here.
Yep.
James is going to tell you the activities we're going to do.
So tomorrow we're going to go to the glacier. And there's also this bridge you can walk across, which I'm not overly excited about because I don't like heights, and the gap between the planks is a couple of feet by the looks of it. So yeah. That should be fun. And yeah, just chill out a little bit because there's not been too much chilling out for the last 2 weeks. We've loved it, but it's been pretty full on. So today, yeah. Tomorrow will be quite cool just to have a base.
All right. So we'll see you at the glacier.
Okay, so that glacier on your left there is the Passu Glacier. That's what we're aiming for. This little star here is where we were staying. Now, the one option is to head south along the Karakoram Highway and then cut in and walk towards this viewing point. It's meant to be beautiful. It's like a 3 or 4 hour walk, nothing difficult, perfect. However, we also heard there was a slightly longer walk that left from further north. So we got told we could go north and basically cut in to another viewing point of the second glacier, right about here. From there, we thought we could walk up and over the valley through this little plateau and then see the Passu Glacier from that side. So it's like two birds, one stone. And then heading back to our accommodation. So all up, I think it was meant to be something like 16 kilometers. Nothing we haven't done before. All sounds easy, right? How wrong we were. Unfortunately, the sound on my camera stopped working for some reason. So this is me blabbering on about how the first glacier that we got to is non-existent. There's no glacier there. And secondly, there's not really a discernible path at all. We're pretty much rock climbing over most of these things, and now we're heading up that hill slash mountain. There's no rope, no gear, and no path. So here we go.
Okay, so we just did like probably 6K through this little valley, maybe less, 5K. Trying to get to the Passu Glacier because we've been hoping to see a glacier. So after about an hour of walking, we found it! James, how do you feel?
Pretty tired, but the glacier's worth it. This is a good one. The other one, yeah, this is nice.
How hungry are you?
I badly need like 12 Snickers and a can of Coke.
We stupidly didn't bring any snacks. Not much water either. No one was open this morning, so I'm pretty hungry. Anyway, we'll press on.
So, although the glacier was great, we can see no way of actually getting back down to town. Jay is currently down the cliff trying to experiment which way we go. And he's actually on his way back up because it doesn't look like it's possible.
So again, the sound's not working on my camera for some reason, but here we go. This is me going on about how usually we like to be safe and do things, you know, in a relatively controlled manner. This was not one of those times. We were genuinely like dropping down cliff faces, and now we're on this, what can only be described as a goat path with quite a sheer drop to the one side and very, very loose and slippery rocks. After about 8 hours, we made it to the bottom. It probably was one of the more stupid things we've done, and we've done quite a few stupid things. But hey, we're still here, we're still pressing on.
So we've both woken up kind of sore. How are you feeling, James?
My legs are screwed.
Yes, they didn't really... walk didn't really go quite as well as planned. Still interesting, but lots of scrambling over rocks. It was about
70% hell, 30% fun.
Yeah, it was about nine hours of walking. Anyway, we're packing up. We're gonna go check out a bridge. And then we're heading to the Shimshel Valley. Hopefully the weather holds up, because if you get into the valley and it starts raining or gets really windy, they just shut down the road and you get stuck in there. Which would be bad.
Very bad.
We'll be right back.
Okay, I'm gonna cut the video short. I'm gonna end it here, just because there's so much more that we keep doing in Pakistan. This country is fantastic, and the video would just go on forever if I tried to include everything in here. It'd be like over an hour long. So appreciate you watching it till the end. Thank you so much. Please like and subscribe. And in the next video, we finally make it to the Chinese border. Catch you soon.